Women. You know, I think most people picture women riding on the back of a motorcycle. But you know what? There's a growing demographic of women who love to ride motorcycles. And that couldn't be any more true today. And a lot of those women, well, let's just say the special ones, ride a Ducati. Why don't we talk to one right now? Meet Palm Beach Biker Chick. Well, that's what she calls herself on Instagram anyway. She started off on a Harley, still rides a BMW, but if you ask her what her favorite motorcycle is, well, it's a Ducati. Let's have that conversation.
So I've been riding motorcycles about a year and a half now. I was actually born and raised on a sailboat in the water. And my dad, when we got here around 13 years old, he bought a Harley. And I loved sitting on the back of the Harley with him and going around riding. So what attracted me to riding motorcycles and got me interested in the hobby is just feeling excited about learning a new trade, learning something that intimidated me and conquering the two wheels. So my first two wheels was actually a Vespa, and I went out riding one day with a whole bunch of girlfriends, and they were riding big girl bikes, and I realized that I wanted to shift gears and go faster and conquer more than just a twist and turn bike. So after the Vespa, we live right by a Harley Davidson dealership, so we've always saw Harleys coming and going. So one day we stopped in there and ended up leaving with a little Sportster. That's how we figured out what first bike we wanted. So riding on the back of a motorcycle was fun for sure, you know, but there's a thing about being in control and being able to master the demon between your legs, so to speak, you know. You're just on a joyride and you're able to see the sights and everything like that, but you're not really feeling the power and the roar of the engine being on the back of a motorcycle. So what attracted me to Ducati one day, and I sat on the Monster and I was able to put my feet down, I was able to hold it up, and the salesman said, go ahead, take a test drive. I threw my helmet on, got on this bike and went out on the street, and it was light and it was rideable and it was fast, and I was screaming in my helmet the whole time, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. It had a quick shifter, it had all these things that, you know, riding a bigger, heavier bike didn't have for me, and I was so excited and I was so hooked on the Ducati brand after that. Everything in my Instagram and my social media, everything turned into Ducati and Italian and handmade and performance. So the bike that I actually test rode up there at the shop that day was just a regular Monster. It wasn't the SP version. And I do like top of the line models with every bike that I get. So unfortunately, I had to wait for the SP to come out, put a deposit down, and just waited and waited, and every day was worried about when is this bike coming. And the Ducati app, you know, if you order a bike, it comes in on the Ducati app. You can see when it's, you know, through the process, which is pretty cool. And we were just waiting for this bike. So in all honesty, after I rode that first Monster, it was just about waiting for the SP to come out. So there's just no comparison between a Sportster and a Ducati at all. I get on this and I can ride, and the rideability and the maneuverability and just the quality of my Ducati is far superior than any bike that I have ever ridden. I get on this bike and I feel sexy and I feel exotic and I want to twist and I want to shift and I want to turn, and it just makes me want to keep riding and not get off the entire time. So the color scheme of the bike, I was worried that I wasn't going to like the fading of the red into the black, because we all like, as Ducati riders, the red. The red is iconic and marks the Ducati brand. But as I saw the bike in person and sat on it and saw myself in a picture on the bike, it is sexy, sexy, sexy. So the styling of the bike with the circle headlight just sets it apart from any other bike that's out on the road. The lines of the tank that I look down on when I'm riding and I'm twisting and I'm going fast, and I can just get down over the tank. The styling is amazing. So from the first moment walking into Two Wheels World and dealing with the salesman in that store, it has been absolutely amazing. And I delivering the bike and buying the bike and feeling the excitement and wanting to ride this bike home and having the salesman walk me through all the modes and how to put it into rain mode for my first ride home on 95 and just learning the bike has been amazing. So of course, when you get a new bike, you put miles on it. Within the first week, you're ready for that first service. You don't want to get off the bike. So it was pretty quick when I wanted to get that first service in, and I was able to get right in for that first service. And unfortunately, about 2 days before my service appointment, I picked up a long screw on the road, and I woke up the next morning with a flat rear tire. So that put a damper in my day and in my riding and everything, and called around trying to find a new tire for the bike. And Two Wheels World was absolutely amazing. They had the tire in stock. We got the bike down there and it worked in my schedule. They got me right in as an emergency call, because of course we all know that a flat tire is an emergency on our bike, because how are we supposed to play without that tire? So they got us right in and it was absolutely amazing. So the most amazing thing about my Ducati is it gives me just enough power and more some to be able to feel like I'm conquering something out there on the road, to make me feel scared a little bit and safe at the same time, not overpowered, but still on that brink of, oh my gosh, I just did this and that's amazing. I can take this bike out by myself and not have to worry about turning and not have to worry about, I can't do a U-turn here, I have to go around the block. I can just flick this thing around, I can get in and out of traffic. When I get down and I start wanting to go faster and the bike turns into its name, which is a monster, and it just growls at me, and I just have this huge smile on my face and I just want to keep going and be faster. And then when I get to a stoplight and I look around and I see people checking out my bike, I know what they're checking out. They're checking out this amazing Italian-made machine that I'm on, and I feel so cool. And that's part of the brand, just being stylish and amazing. And this Ducati has been something that I fall asleep thinking about. I wake up and the first thing I want to do before I even check on the kids is run out to the garage and get on this bike just to make sure it was okay. And if I could sleep next to this bike at night, I for sure would, because it's just has been an amazing experience for me, and it's had everything that I've wanted out of a bike. It has the speed, it has the rideability for a short lady like me, and of course it has the style that I would never compromise.